Hello, I'm Andreas Fiewig and I'm working for the Prinect service. We have prepared three different videos for you about ganging. How to create gang files, manual ganging with SignalGang and Sheet Optimizer, and automatic ganging with SignalGang Server. In this video, we will show you how to create gang jobs with the SignalGang Server. Before we configure a planned task for the SignalGang server and create a job in the cockpit, we have to define a paper for ganging, a plate template in Signal, a product part template, and we have to generate a filter for the gang server which jobs are to gang on the job. In administration printing materials, we should define at the customer side gang paper, so they should have the maximum format of the press. They should be with the right grain direction, type of material and grammature, and it makes sense to define the quality from the value of the paper grade and the grammature. We also recommend in Signal Station to create a plate template for ganging. On this plate template, we have to look that the color bar is on the right position and outside of the gang area. For this reason, we should place the color bar so close as possible to the grip. Further, we need a product part template for ganging. In the product part template, we define all necessary parameters to gang. Here we define also the kind of paper ganging. In plates, we define that paper from our MDS with our quality. We define the press, the plate template with the color bar, and the work style. In optimization, we have to define the parameters for ganging. So here we allow to rotate business cards or flyers automatically, so good as possible. If there is a fold inside, the folding will be placed parallel to the grain direction. The quantity of calculated sheets is a multiple of 100. We can also define here some make ready sheets for post press. In geometry, we have to look that on the left and on the right margin our sheet breaks are. So in this area, we don't want to print gang jobs. And on the button and the margin, we should reserve the place for grip and the color bar. We want not to print gang jobs in this area. The costing, these both values are the balance between make ready preparation, costs of plates and make ready sheets on the press, and the good production on the press. In our experience, these values are generally to use. Now, additionally, we need here that rating. The rating is necessary for the decision of the gang server if it makes sense to gang a job and to create a job. So if the usage is below 50%, he will not gang jobs. If the usage of the paper is higher than 50%, he will do it. So normally in real production the customer would here define 80%. In that way that he would only accept gang forms who are filled by paper usage if they are more than 80% filled. Okay. I will save now this setting. The last setting is to do in tools, job import for gang jobs. Here we look to the gang pool and we can see all our gang jobs, and we can create here filter for the gang server. So I take for the filter the same quality, paper grade 2 with 240 gram paper. We define here then we want to see the printing material, the quality. And I can define here it has to be equal. So you can see that in this condition the Signa gang server will see nothing, no job. But if we define exactly the right quality, then he will find these jobs. It is also possible to define here, for example, I want to look only for black and white jobs. It has to be equal K, then he would only look for black and white jobs. In our example, we ignore that. We only will look for paper class 2 and 240 gram paper. And the gang server will find then these jobs to gang. When we leave that window, the filter is automatically saved. Now we have created all necessary resources to create a planned task for the gang server. We create here a new task. We can name it also 2-240, paper class and grammature, description, gang server. We can enable the task. We can here define now placeholders for job ID, and we can use for example the year, then the month, and then the day of the month, and in the end we should also define a serial number. This is necessary to have a unique job ID in the cockpit later on. It's not allowed to have the same job ID in the cockpit twice. So this is only a counter. The second job is then named 2, 3, 4, and so on. The job name could be defined in the same way. So we can, for example, define here the template name, the product part template. This we have to define now. And we have created a product part template for the gang server, also with the material quality. Here we define now the filter. And here we can define when the gang server should start automatically to create gang jobs in the cockpit. This is now our planned task. We can start the planned task also manually here, and we have now to wait for the result. After the Signa gang server has created a job, We will see the result here. If we double click on that icon, we can open the job report. How many sheets, the quantity of the sheets, and all the one-ups, how often they are placed on the sheet, and also an overview about the gang jobs on sheet number 1 and sheet number 2. The job is automatically now available in the cockpit, generated by the Signa Gang server. We can find him in a folder in the classic structure named Signa Gang Jobs. We see on the icon that this is the gang job with a lot of source IDs, source jobs. And if you open this gang job, our gang sheets are here inside. And in Manage Gang Pool, we see that no other gang jobs are in the gang pool anymore. The Signa Gang server and also the manual sheet optimizer will clean up that folder if a gang job was successfully created.